have this underhook and the guy's up on your feet, there's no reason for you to rush this technique, right? I think a lot of guys, they want to shoot. I see some people shooting when this guy's head's down. If this guy's head's down and I try to shoot through it, this guy's head's down, I try to shoot through it, he's going to sprawl, he's going to get his legs back, I'm going to be too extended, my attack's not going to work. But when you have somebody in a front headlock, as long as you're being, you're not going to stalemate this position when you're up on your feet, right? Maybe they'll stalemate it down if you guys are down on your knees. But as long as you're working and you're moving in this position, they're not going to stalemate it. And it's taking a lot more energy out of this guy than it is out of you. Fighting a front headlock compared to having somebody in a front headlock is completely different. Completely different. He's losing a lot of energy, and I'm gaining energy. So I don't have to do much. You know? I'm over top of him. I can feel what he's moving, the way he's moving. And I know how I'm going to attack in these positions. So this is the guy who's in the stressful position. So we can keep him here as long as he wants. You know, until he eventually is going to fight his head out and we get to our attack. But we don't want to rush. We don't want to rush this. When his head's over on this side, we don't want to rush it and try to shoot too quickly. You'll be able to feel it. As his head pops up, I'm lowering my level. Right? I don't want to rush it and shoot through his head. That's just going to cause problems with the technique. So the next thing that we're going to do is we're going to kind of put it all together. All right, we're gonna start from our feet, drive into him, snap him down, bring him down to his face, underhook, take him up, and instead of shooting, we're gonna fake. Fake on him, snap him back down, spin behind. So you guys know how to do all this stuff, you've been working on it this session, but we're just gonna put it together piece by piece. So I collar tie, thumb block, I drive forward, he pressures into me, I snap, I go down to my knee, I underhook, drive him back up to his feet, I use my elbow to put his head on the opposite side in that little hole, I wait for his head to pop up, as his head pops up, I fake, that leg goes back, I snap again, take him back down, put his elbow to the mat, spin behind him. Alright. That's all the stuff. I mean, missing the ankle pick and going the other direction, but that's like the majority of the stuff we worked on this morning. And that system right there will make people tired, really tired. If you get someone into that that system where they have to fight out of that multiple times in a match, and you're faking them, you're putting them back down, you're standing them up, you're making them fight out of the front headlock, that's gonna make them really tired. Really tired. You do it once and somebody gets tired. Do it a couple times. Then that's where they start breaking, cut them, take them down, cut them, take them down, multiple times. So this time I'll do it kind of like I'm drilling. Here, drive forward, snap down, my knee, underhook, drive him up, head goes to the opposite side, fake, snap, back down to my knee. Another time, slow for you guys. Power tie, thumb block, drive forward, snap, down to my knee, underhook, driving back up to his feet, push his head to the side, this head pops up, I fake, that leg goes back, snap it down again, back down to my knee. Circle behind him. Cool. You guys got any questions? All right, let's try it. One, two.